How about I share one of my theories and give you something new to think about? Just to think about something new that you might not have ever thought about before. This is a theory I have about consciousness in multicellular organisms like humans and slugs and maybe even 500-celled creatures or 3-celled creatures that are unified, that are beings in themselves as well as composed of individual beings, lots of them, or a few of them. And I had questions that I've given myself some preliminary answers to, some hypothetical answers to. Questions concerning the mechanism by which individual cells can be unified into a conscious entity that has a self-reference and a self-perception, a self-awareness and volition through the body. I had questions of how the person that a slug is, or your neighbor, or your dog, or whatever, the person that we've arisen as, or formed as, whatever, however consciousness comes to be in the first place. Well, all these questions of wondering where consciousness came from in all these cells, I went in my thought back to those individual cells, thinking about them. How do they exist? Well, I've come to believe, but I can't really know in a scientific sense, I've come to believe that an individual cell is conscious. It feels, it sees, or perceives it in some way. I don't know how, and I don't suspect it needs to be that complex or anything. But I think that the individual cell is conscious. So in our brain and body, all these individuals are conscious, I believe. And like fields that are like gravity and electromagnetism, these fields interact and mesh all throughout space at any distance instantaneously. There's no transport of force, or at least I'm on the side of the scientists that don't think there's a messenger of force that has a speed or anything. I think that it is just a force that goes out like that. And what is to separate consciousness from being field-like over a body through the connections between the body? Like, in essence, I believe consciousness is inherently telepathic, that consciousness builds on itself and can mesh and meld with itself to create a single field of consciousness with a single identity. And one of the things that got me into thinking about this was one quantum physicist I heard talking on a radio interview. He was talking about a single brain cell, a neuron in a human. All the calcium ion channels and synapses, the neurotransmitter vesicles, did I say that already? I don't know. No, I didn't say that already. The neurotransmitter vesicles, all the different neurotransmitters, all the different receptors for the nerve neurotransmitters, All these different things, the Golgi apparatus in the cell, the mitochondria, all these things create a cellular potential, a computational potential for whether these single cells fire on or off. And that firing on or off is enough to coordinate incoming stimuli to activate our senses. Signal goes, and you feel it, or see it, or hear it, or smell it, or whatever. And that on off of the cell firing, the signals going to and from and to, all those signals is like there's a computational potential of the brain, and that coordinates basically every aspect of our living awareness. So the single brain cell has all this cellular computational potential that exists by nature of the quantum machinery and this and the molecular machinery that allows variation to happen, that allows the cell to fire or not to fire, like the body jumping up or the body huddling down or speech emanating forth, these signals that come out of the whole body. The whole body of the human has a lot of output signals, but single cells just fire or not fire. Brain cells, I mean nerve cells. So this computational potential gives a cell a chance to be a person like us that has thoughts and feelings, because all that potential is enough for something more than nothing. And it seems to me that if cells are conscious in this way, and like we are in some way, then the only explanation of consciousness in a whole body is telepathy. And that's one of my most personally compelling theories. What do you think, Ian? I'm very interested to hear what you have to think about that. Have a good day.